Habib, come over here.
Well, I'm mowing. Okay. What's up?
The smith just left for work again. Look at his yard.
Smiths and their yards. They're so smelly. What is that smell anyway?
Right. But their yard, it's terrible. Don't keep it up at all. No fertilizer, no mowing. Just let it run loose. And those daisies. God damn those daisies. You know, once you let one daisy into the cul-de-sac, there's daisies everywhere.
Well, at least he doesn't have dandelions yet. That would just destroy the whole neighborhood. We'd have to move out.
I like you, Habib. I don't care what those other people say about those I like you. You got a good head on your shoulder.
Thank you.
But we have to do something about Mr. Smith.
Well, we can't go to the committee because they seem to like them for some reason. I think it's the wife.
Mrs. Smith.
Don't they have a kid?
Yes, and a dog craps in my yard.
I got a couple ideas in my head to do with that dog.
We can't touch the dog. That's not right.
But it would be delicious. Wait, you guys don't eat dog?
Neither do Muslims.
They probably
do. He's a reformist.
I never said I was a Muslim.
Regardless of his religion, he's a reformist. Oh god.
So what are we gonna do about this yard? I mean, you know, if you had an idea, I'm all in, man. I got your back. You know me. I mean, tell me what you're thinking. Any idea? You're silent over there, man.
The dog.
Not the dog. We already went over that. That's inhumane or whatever nonsense. Even though it does crap in everyone's yard.
And looks mighty delicious.
But what if no one found out about the dog?
Forget about the dog. You know, every day back in my hometown, people would kidnap other people, and that would be the leverage you would use, man. And that worked, because there's nothing more important to you than your family. I'm telling you, the kid.
The kid? What are you talking about?
Well, I don't know. I don't know anything. I'm just suggesting.
Keep that suggestion to yourself. We're gonna kidnap the dog. It's final.
Whatever you say, man. I got your back.
End scene.
What the hell was that?
I love how Sickly was just giving, like, dude, take the bait. Take the damn bait.
I was just like, seriously, Lowlightt. Damn it.
What?
You don't want to kidnap the kid after all?
If we kidnap the dog... The plan is to kidnap the dog. You fuck it up and kidnap the kid instead.
Okay. I see where you're going.
So, which one's good, which one's bad? Black, white? White, black?
Well, red is stop, green is go. So green's okay. Good.
That does not seem like it'll end up well for Low.
No, it will not.
In the middle of that, you're supposed to decide whether or not it ends good or bad.
Nothing was happening in the middle. You just kind of were flailing around while Sickly was just trying to get you to get the scene moving. I love how it almost seemed like Sickly was the mastermind and Lo was the minion.
Hey, more reason for me to try and free myself from him and become the master, and that's why Lowlightt has suspicions.
Okay, I guess it's my turn. Gonna establish a scene, and it's going to be with... who should I put it with? It's gonna be with no one. It's just, I'm gonna establish a scene. It's in the middle of the day, and I am walking the dog as Roberta Smith.
Okay. Any other characters come up?
Shouldn't.
Parents? No, other neighbors?
No. They're off at work. So,
okay.
So I take the dog for a walk. I think Habib would be out there, so it's with Sickly. Okay. He's still mowing his lawn. And I guess Mr. Thompson went in for to get, you know, rest or whatever after going, like, make plans or whatever. So I take the dog, I start walking the dog, and I take it around the cul-de-sac and make sure it crabs in everybody's yard.
Oh my god, that's awesome.
And I guess you would take offense to it. It's like, hey, what are you doing? Or something like that. So I get to the Sura's yard, and the dog looks at the Habib.
Don't you even think about it. One small poopy drop, and your pork chops. I'm still mowing here. I've got the blades.
Yo, what's up, Daddy-O?
Don't Daddy-O me. Keep your dog away from my lawn.
What can you really do? I mean, you touch me and I have the cops on you in 2 seconds.
Yeah, well, just
don't
because...
Don't think we don't know what you're doing in your basement at night, keeping the lights on, and all those strange sounds. Everybody knows who you are.
You know, every Smith I've seen in law enforcement, they think that just because my name's Habib, I'm a terrorist. Let me tell you what, I'm reformed. I don't do that crazy crap. Your dad can just... he can nose around all he wants. He's not going to find anything because there's nothing to find.
Yeah, but...
Raven's dad is a cop.
Yes. Yeah, but I'm sure you have something up your sleeve anyways. I see you always talking with the neighbor. God, I hate since we moved here from LA. Can't even have an honest gang war.
I'm wearing a sleeveless shirt. I don't think I get what you're saying here.
I let the dog whiz in the yard and walk away.
Smiths!
I think the scene will end badly, so I'm giving Raven a red one.
Oh, I didn't even have a question to ask. I just thought that'd be hella funny.
How can I make this end badly for him without kidnapping him?
Why can't you kidnap him?
I don't know if it's early enough or not.
Go for it!
Alright, kid, that's it. Your dog has done enough damage. I grab the kid, the dog runs away, I take him down into my my house.
No, yes, you take him into the toilet, the guest bathroom.
Yes, the guest bathroom underneath the stairs.
When my dad hears of this, he'll have your balls in a sling!
Where do you guys even get these sayings from? You're crazy.
Habib!
Covers mouth, pulls out hanky, and gags him. Slams the door closed.
I think that's an end scene right there.
Oh god.
Now, Sickly, the question you have to ask yourself is, for your next scene, do you involve Clark right off the bat, or do you try to take care of everything yourself?
I am not going to make that decision. I'm going to say the scene's going to end poorly for me.
Oh!
You're resolving poorly.
Yes.
Okay, so what happens, Lou? I'm locked up in the closet. Dogs run away.
He said it's going to end badly, right?
Yes. Where's Johnny boy? Down in the well!
Oh, God.
No, I think the scene is going to be... involve Sickly and Raven's character.
Okay.
Raven's character is still gagged sitting on the toilet, and Sickly's character is pacing back and forth trying to cope with what he has just done and the ramifications of what he has just done, and has to make a decision on what he does next.
Okay.
And of course we know that decision will end badly.
Oh, right.
So the scene could involve Raven if you choose to, but for the most part he's gagged in the toilet. So it's kind of like a, almost a monologue.
Right.
Asking for resolve is a signal that you also want an obvious conflict.
Right, but I wanted that, so there.
I think that Sickly panicking should talk to Clark, and Clark basically goes, "What the fuck, man?"
I was thinking that, but I was thinking it would be more fun to keep Clark out of it to begin with.
We can always do flashbacks. It doesn't have to be chronological.
This is right, not Naruto. Right.
I was thinking it would be more fun to keep Clark out of the incident to begin with, so that gives Sickly more times to make bad decisions. Then he brings in Clark to try to fix everything.
Well, we basically have one more time around before Act 2, anyway. So it doesn't really matter if he brings him in now.
I guess, but...
Since I'm pretty much just chilling here.
Yeah, you're gagged. How about this? Sickly's trying to figure out what the hell he's going to do now that he's got this kid tied up in his bathroom.
Under the stairs.
Under the stairs.
Under the sea.
Clark forces his way into Habib's house looking for the tools that he lent Habib and he's never gotten back. But because, you know, Clark's so old and straightforward like that, he just lets himself into the house.
He's got a plan on how to kidnap the dog.
Yes!
Since he just saw it crap in his yard. So this scene, I guess, starts off just as Habib gets in the house and Clark realizes that his lawn has been shot upon.
Habib!
Hold on, I'm coming.
I've
got something important. Give me one second, man. What am I doing about this kid? What
Get
am I
doing?
I mean, I thought about the plan, and what am I going to do
Habib!
Now? What am I going to do? I'm coming. Oh, it's you. What's up?
Habib, that dog just crapped in my yard again.
Yeah, he peed in mine. He's gone now. Don't worry.
No, we're going to get the dog. We're going to take it.
No, the dog got loose and ran. It's cool. I don't think he's going to come back.
What do you mean it got loose?
Well, the kid was over here, and the dog peed on my yard, so I grabbed... The dog ran. That's all that matters.
What the hell, Habib? What was that?
It's the solution to our problems, man. I'm telling you. This is from the very beginning.
Habib.
What?
Where's the dog?
He ran away. It's not like they have this place fenced in. He's probably some other's cul-de-sac with a French poodle just, you know, going at it.
Habib,
shut up
the
in
hell
there.
Is that?
The kid. I thought I made that clear. The solution is in my bathroom right now, man. Isn't this awesome? The Smiths are going to be gone, you know? They have no choice.
Are you a freaking moron?
Moron?
The kid's dad's a cop. And you're a fucking terrorist.
I am not a terrorist. I am reformed.
What the hell does a reformed terrorist mean? It means he's a terrorist. You're a freaking idiot.
Yeah, well, I didn't see you taking action. You're just sitting there being quiet and, you know, well, I don't know what to do. We have a problem. There's dogs pooping on our yard.
That's because I don't kidnap kids, you jackass.
Well, I do. You got a problem with that?
Maybe I do.
Well, fine. We'll do things your way. You take over now.
My way? Habib? I'm this close to calling the cops on you.
Then call them. I'll tell them it was your idea.
Who are they gonna believe? A nice, elderly American? A war hero? Or a terrorist?
I'll have you know that I was not a leader of a terrorist group. And they can see that.
Thumps in the bathroom.
What'd you say,
Raven?
Something thumps in the bathroom.
Come on. Seriously, I just cleaned that toilet, man.
Really Sickly.
Opens door.
I tried to get out by ramming the door, but I kind of went unconscious.
You killed the kid?
I did not kill... He killed himself. It's suicide. See, now the problem that was the solution is now solved, so the solution is solved. That's
Habib,
perfect.
Shut up.
I didn't kill him, though.
He looks dead.
Well, I'm just a terrorist. How would I know?
I think we're almost at the end there.
Habib, go outside.
This is my house, man.
Habib, outside, now.
Whatever.
Slams the door. I know. Phone ring. And Clark picks it up because it's habit.
Ring. Ring.
What? What? Speak English.
I came home early and saw my dog coming across the yard and picked him up. Apparently, Roberta was supposed to come and walk him, but didn't show up. Have you seen him?
See, this is your problem. Letting kids run around all the time, letting dogs crap everywhere. You need better parenting.
Mr. Thompson, why are you at Habib's house?
Why wouldn't I be at Habib's house? Friends!
I think that got detracted a bit when you kicked Sickly out, but okay, let's end it there. At the close of the phone call.
Oh my god, what the hell happened?
I was going to check the kid after I kicked Sickly out, but it turned into my scene instead of Sickly.
No!
Raven's unconscious, so he gets a red die.
I think I'm gonna give my die to Habib. To the Sickly, just because it was amusing. He's just caught in the middle of nowhere, somehow being the mastermind.
Oh god.
Are you gonna give your dice too low?
I'm gonna give my die to Raven.
Because he's unconscious!
Yes!